Bum to die trying.
Science.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to test a hypothesis that big old sparks can kill a PC.
Or they'll overclock it. So every time we build a PC, we get a lot of YouTube comments saying that we should be wearing static wristbands to protect the components.
I am now safely grounded and can build a PC without endangering components, health, or safety.
So we've never had issues with it, but it probably is a good idea. So we're going to use my Van de Graaff generator that I built, and we're going to shock a whole lot of PC components and see what actually fails.
Michael, who keeps a Van de Graaff generator in his bedroom at all times.
Why do you keep a Van de Graaff generator in your house?
I built it and I love it and it's fun at parties. Drunk people love getting shocked, absolutely.
Being Michael's friend has so many fringe benefits. So you might think we've constructed, because we're using science and testing a hypothesis in search of more knowledge, that we would be using a sophisticated set of tools to migrate the spark from the Van de Graaff generator to the PC case. Instead, ladies and gentlemen, we're using Michael.
I have this little whisk so that
That's
I don't have to
a little
directly.
Whisk, but it is a whisk.
So I'm gonna touch the Van de Graaff generator and touch the components that we wanna test out and we can see what happens.
Michael's gonna attempt to kill this quickly and efficiently by zapping the PCB board.
Okay, got some, oh, we turned it off.
But will it restart?
There's nothing important on that, right?
Is it dead?
I think it might be dead. The computer isn't recognizing it anymore. Motherboard's still good though.
What do you wanna zap next?
Let's do RAM.
Oh yeah.
That was a good one.
I love how you hit it with multiple zaps. Oh, that's two chips and both connectors.
If that doesn't do it.
Hey, Michael?
Yeah.
I think you've zapped it.
All right, let's see if it still works.
That's a postcode.
It's dead.
So, RAM.
Yep, it's susceptible to electric shock.
Multiple violent electric shocks. Dude, you hit it four times with like half-inch long sparks.
Might as well go all out.
I mean, never to piss you off.
Do we have any components left?
Yes, we actually have the GPU.
All right, so I think it's the capacitors maybe that
get overloaded.
Dying. So I'm gonna go straight for them.
No, oh, saw a flicker that time. GPU's still going. Oh, I can feel the hairs on my arm.
Did we kill it? We might have killed it. Like, not just the video card, but maybe the whole motherboard.
Shut it down, let's pull the video card.
Okay. Maybe things connected to the motherboard shouldn't be shocked. Oh, I wanted to shock the motherboard. Okay, it's still good. So, video card dead. I'm noticing a trend here.
That violent electric shocks applied directly to the components and the PCBs cause failure?
Something like that.
Uh-huh.
I think that's part of the scientific process. Observation. Okay, let's try doing just shocking the case and see if that does anything, and then we can move on to the motherboard.
Ow, ow. Shocking the case. Doesn't seem like anything's happening.
Okay.
We're going for the motherboard.
Oh, I wouldn't want to be that motherboard right now. But if you're thinking to yourself, what I really should be doing right now is advancing my education and learning skills to get me ahead in the modern workplace, we have an answer for you, ladies and gentlemen.
What is this then?
Lynda.com/DI. Well, this is useful, but if you want to learn like better Photoshop skills, programming, or any of, well, actually an incredible array of subjects, Lynda.com/DIY, give yourself a free week, support the show, and keep us doing stuff like this.
Whatever this is.
Over and over again.
All right, I'm gonna plug it back in and see if we can kill the machine itself.
All right, the litany of death. The hard drive, PCB, dead. Memory, dead. GPU, dead. Case does not die. Now the motherboard.
Ah! Ow.
Oh! That's dead. Michael, it's dead.
Michael, never. You can
stop. Are you wearing an anti-static strap?
I am. I guess we should probably test out if these actually work.
Back in the bucket.
So there will be an initial shock.
Yes, I would call that a shock.
But we saw before that shocking the case didn't matter, so we're grounded to the case, and then now.
Nothing.
No shock. I bet I could. Yep, can touch you. Now.
Ow.
Okay, that's not too bad. It's magic.
Yeah, but I'm still getting zapped.
All right, so these do work. You were right, YouTube. We're sorry.
So you're totally gonna start building PCs wearing static straps now?
Absolutely not.
If you'd like to see what we can do with Twitch to help your Android phone control everything or make lockpicks out of metal scraps so you can break into anything, you should check out these episodes right here on YouTube. And if you think we're idiots, do us a favor, tweet at DieTryin or email DieTryin@revision3.com or comment down below. I'm Patrick Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
We'll see you next week on DieTryin.
Later.
You keep doing that, dude.
It hurts a lot.
And you keep doing it.
Hit it again.
Ah! Yow!
I don't like the strap.
Ah, that hurts! Ow! Wow, dude.